Right, can come to order, please. Okay, can I welcome everybody to this meeting of the Cabinet. Thank you for your attendance. Go through the preliminary items first of all. Members' code of conduct, declarations of interest. There's an obvious interest that a number of members need to declare in connection with item 5, admission arrangements for schools, because a number of us are school governors. For those, can people who are school governors please put their hand up? Shirley, can you recall them? You got everybody? Okay. Right, any other cabinet members wish to declare any other interests on any other items? Okay, great. Item 2 are the minutes of the last meeting. Can we agree that I sign them as a true record?
Challenging. There will always be those voluntary controlled schools and the Wirral's coordinated scheme for 2020-2021. Thank you.
OK, thanks very much, Bernie, taking us through that. Any Cllr members got any questions or comments that we should make? If not, just put that recommendation that Bernie's moved to on page 23. Is that agreed, Cllr?
It is.
OK, thank you very much. And then the final item on today's agenda is item number 6, which is the called in item on the local plan and the recommendations from Environment Overview and Scrutiny Committee of the 7th of February. I'm going to ask George Davies, a Cllr member, to take us through this, please, George.
Certainly, thank you, Phil. And can I just explain, Phil, that there is an evidence base behind what I'm actually saying, and for every Cabinet member I will produce that last year to send that to the Chair some today, so it's about 5 days afterwards, which basically gives you the evidence base why we're doing it at what time as well. So if I'm just elaborating slightly further on that. An appropriate, robust local plan which meets the housing needs of our residents is a must. It is a vital duty which we will do other. I have been clear from the outset that our local plan will be underpinned by the views and needs of rural residents, which includes the highest levels of democratic oversight and scrutiny by my fellow councillors. This is why I am pleased to respond to the recommendations of the scrutiny committee and set out the avenues for elected members of all parties to play a fundamental role in shaping the Wirral's local plan. In response to the Environment Overview and Scrutiny Committee's recommendations, which I welcome, I am presenting to Cabinet a table that identifies all the technical studies commissioned from third parties required to support the current local plan work. Their publications, dates and costs were in on paragraph 31 of the National Planning Policy Framework states that the preparation and review of all local plan policies should be underpinned by relevant and up-to-date evidence. All local planning authorities rely on these technical studies to gather the evidence required for the examination and ensure that the local plan is ultimately found sound by the planning inspector appointed by the Secretary of State. I have written to the party group leaders seeking a meeting with them to discuss the formation of a cross-party advisory group on the local plan, and I will report back to Cabinet with the terms of reference for this once my meeting has taken place with them. I have asked officers to arrange a series of briefings for all members of the Council on the local plan process and future timetable. I will chair these meetings and will be happy as a Cabinet member with the support of officers to answer all questions from backbench active members. Within the Council's budget there is a specific cost centre where all the local plan costs can be identified and monitored as the local plan work progresses. There is allocated one-off additional budget of £1.2 million, funded from use of reserves and other resources for expenditure to March 2020. It is recommended, one, to receive and consider the recommendations of the Environment Overview Scrutiny Committee on the 7th of February. Note two, note and endorse the actions of the Cabinet member with portfolio for housing and planning in A, setting out a table identifying all technical studies, their publication dates and their costs. B, writing to the party group leaders seeking a meeting with them to discuss the formation of a cross-party advisory group on the local plan. And C, arranging a series of briefings for all members of the Council on the local planning process and future timetable. 3, request a Cabinet member to report back to Cabinet for approval of the tender reference of a cross-party local plan advisory group. And 4, authorises Corporate Director for Business Management in consultation with the Cabinet Member with the portfolio for housing and planning to undertake decisions related to the approval and publication of the evidence base and associated technical reports relevant to the preparation of the local plan. So move.
Thank you, George. Thanks, George. Okay, so I think essentially we're accepting the recommendations from the scrutiny committee as printed in the minutes from the meeting on the 7th of February. Just to amplify a couple of things George has said. I think point number one, I think there is, I think George spelled it out, there is absolute agreement that this is something that all members need to be involved in and have the opportunity to scrutinise and sort of ask questions about. But secondly, we're on a tight timetable here. We've got to deliver our local plan in accordance with the deadlines that we previously set out. And I think our commitment is that we are working at pace to ensure that happens. So providing that we can, providing we can stick to those key deadlines, reducing our local plan, I think that there is absolute agreement that asks, if you like, of the scrutiny committee should be agreed, and I think you set out, George, exactly how we're going to do that and what we're going to report back to cabinet on further. So that's really all I want to say. Anybody want to add anything else to what George has moved?
Thanks, Phil. Just very briefly to say, I've stated every time I've mentioned this, I think it's under disgrace that the government's forcing the thousand targets on Rural Council. And if through the recommendations arising out of that call, Council can come together to express their disgust to government, hopefully they'll change their mind and allow us to set our own targets and just throw away these top down. It's nonsense, absolute nonsense. Thanks, Phil.
And, reiterate the point we've made many times around this table before. We are committed to supporting the ONS figures for housing projections, 488. I've certainly, as leader, written to the Secretary of State, putting that in writing. And that remains our position, because I think that is more an accurate reflection of the needs of Wirral than the much higher figure that the government initially set out, which was 803, and that remains our position. And I think we will continue to make that case to the government at every opportunity that we can in the coming weeks and months. Anything else that anybody wants to add? Okay, so George, you've moved a series of recommendations. Which I hope we can record in the minutes. Yes, you've got them. Okay. So can I ask Cabinet, can we agree those recommendations as we call George? Is that agreed?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much. I've not been notified of any other business, so I'll close the meeting. Thank you for your attendance. Thank you.